Hello guys, welcome back. My name is Asthma and this is NFL news. It's not 49ers news, it's NFL news. Before I start the news, I have a big announcement that's coming up on the 31st of July. Keep an eye on that. It will be 6 p.m. UK British time. Keep an eye on that. I can't wait for you guys to see it. It will be basically, well, I'm not going to say. I'll let you guys see it. But yeah, keep an eye, 6 p.m. British UK time, big announcement coming up. But enough of that, let's get into some news, NFL news. And it's actually yet again another sad news today. So as you can see, theguardian.com/sport, and on The Guardian, this happened Thursday, and it is very sad. New York Jets coach Greg Knapp dies after being struck by a car in California. Very, very sad. The 58-year-old worked closely with the Jets quarterbacks. He was a coach, was riding his bike when he was hit by a car. Terrible shame. But let's read the article. Who's it by? It doesn't say, but it's by The Guardian. So I'll read them. The New York Jets assistant coach Greg Knapp died on Thursday of injuries suffered when he was struck by a car while riding a bicycle near his home in California. He was 58 years of age. Greg Knapp, aka Knappa, was called back home to Haven, where he will be reunited with his dad, his family said in a statement. His family added that Knapp never regained consciousness after being hit by a car in the San Francisco Bay Area on Saturday. Blimey. He was surrounded by wife Charlotte, daughters Jordan, Natalie and Camille, his mother and brother when he died. Greg's infectious personality is most people's first and lasting memory of him, the family said. The phrase, he never met a stranger, and he capitalizes Knapp's zest of life. He had a unique gift to make everyone feel special, and to Knapp they were all were. While his family and friends and players still had so much to learn from him and desperately wish they had more time with him, God called undoable and wanted to go over the game plan directly with him. It will certainly be a masterpiece, just like Greg. Knapp, who lived in Danville, California, was hired by the Jets in January as part of the new coach Robert Saleh's staff, serving as the passing game specialist. The loss of a loved one is always a challenge, but it's harder when it's completely unexpected, Saleh said in a statement issued by the team. Charlotte, Jordan, Natalie and Camille, please accept our most sincere condolences. Greg had so much inner peace about him that people always seem to navigate towards. He lived life in a loving way that helped him connect with people from all walks of life in a unique way. In his short time here, I believe the people in this organization had a chance to experience that connection. Greg, thank you for all that you have shared with us. You'll be missed, brother. Among Knapp's primary roles was the Jets was to help develop quarterback Zach Wilson, the number two overall draft pick in the year's draft. Man, this is hard, Wilson wrote on Instagram. Huge impact on my life in only a few months. Love you, Coach Knapp. Knapp was well liked and respected in the NFL circles, and he established himself as a quarterback guru and one of the league's top offensive minded coaches. Among the others quarterbacks he coached during his career were Steve Young, Michael Vick, Peyton Manning and Matt Ryan. Several Knapp's former teammates and players posted tributes and sent condolences to the coach's family on social media. From all-time greats like Peyton Manning to young players just starting their careers, Greg was a trusted, confident, and very definition of a quarterback whisperer, the Denver Broncos said in a statement. More importantly, the connections and friendships he forged with players, coaches, and staffs, as well as their families, were genuine and special. Knapp had been expected to have a key role in helping offensive coordinator Mike LaFleur and quarterbacks coach Rob Calabres teach and develop Wilson as a 21-year-old quarterback adjusts to the NFL life as the lucky starter for the Jets this season. His legacy is not only working with some of the brightest quarterbacks the league has ever seen, but the countless other across the world. He has had an incredible positive influence on Jets chairman Woody Johnson, who said in a statement. 58 years of age. I mean, Steve Young, Peyton Manning, this guy's had a very good career, and it's such a shame it was taken from him by a car accident. Such a shame. scattering. But we always take things for granted. You never know what's happening around that corner. And it's a shame, a real shame. There's a lot of people sadly passing away before the season even starts. But yeah, that's about it in that article, guys. Yeah, condolences to the families and friends and so forth. And they'll be sadly missed. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Thank you very much for the 39 subscribers as well. Really fortunate, humble, and appreciated that you subscribed. And if you're new subscribers, I'll keep an eye on like 49ers news mainly. And if I see any NFL ones around the world, NFL news, I'll let you know. Plus, I do like gaming streamings and so forth, but mainly on the NFL. But yeah, once again, thank you very much for watching, guys. And I'll see you guys on the next video.